Hi, I'm Chitra Nawbatt with General Catalyst. Today we're joined by Sean Lane, CEO of Olive. Sean, thank you for joining us.
You're welcome. It's good to be here.
Olive is a General Catalyst investment and company in our health assurance network. How does Olive help achieve health assurance, which is bending the cost curve and making quality care more affordable and accessible?
Yeah, effectively, we're automating everything in the enterprise. There's a huge amount of cost that goes into all the workflows and processes that inundate healthcare. Up to $1 trillion, we estimate, is wasted in a lot of these processes and workflows. So we're automating them. We're automating things in revenue cycle, finance, HR, IT, supply chain, pharmacy, clinical operations. So we're creating a lot of value by reducing a lot of the cost associated with these workflows.
Can you share a little bit more of a specific example? Bring it to life for us and the impact.
Sure, so let's take claims, for example. Every health system on the planet submits claims. In the United States, there's a huge insurance process for getting these claims paid. And oftentimes, there are limitations on the amount of procedures you can perform based on certain health plans. And all of this takes a lot of manual processes to figure out. I mean, we're talking hundreds or thousands of people at an organization who solely do nothing but claims administration. We can automate a lot of that work. We can build, you know, software robots and artificial intelligence that make sure that health systems get paid for the work they do without requiring the armies of people to do it.
Sean, artificial intelligence, machine learning, the use of bots, robotic process automation, expedited claims matching between payers and providers. A lot of folks out there are still very skeptical about, does this work? What's the magnitude or the level of value? What does it really do to workforce transformation? What do you say?
Yeah, well, I mean, it's happening every day. We have about 70,000 FTE worth of Olive showing up for work and doing automations every single day. So it's absolutely out there. We're in over 1,000 hospitals across the country. And so it's a real proven technology. The good news is we're just getting started. So we're just scratching the surface on all the automation that can go into a health system. But ultimately, it'll change the entire human experience of healthcare, because when the processes start to get automated, the experience starts to change. Like how you interact with health systems and how you make payments and how you look at a claim and try to understand what is on that piece of paper that you were sent. All that starts to change with automation. So it's very exciting, but it's happening right now.
Can you talk about stages of applying automation, stages of the maturation of this technology and the impact on health systems?
Sure, so we used to start in certain areas and then expand, but there's just no time for that. I mean, there's too many processes that need to be automated. There's too much to gain. So we now only do enterprise-wide automation. So our customers go all in, automating everything across all departments inside their organization from day one. So we don't really do, the dabbling kind of automations don't have a huge impact, and we're over that. So there's still some organizations out there dabbling with automation, but our customers are all in.
And how would you think about the advice you would give health system leaders in terms of the best way to think about their automation strategy and the use of these tools and assets?
Yeah, so it's a very multifaceted strategy, but it has to be at the highest level. There has to be a commitment to really transform your entire organization from end to end. There has to be a commitment to investing in automating any process that can be automated. For one, it will be an expectation of consumers of healthcare. They will expect automation, so you have to meet that expectation. The second, there's no way to compete in the future without automation. Those organizations who fail to automate their processes will no longer be able to compete with those who already have.
How will consumers feel the benefits of this? Why should consumers care?
So when you approach a health system today, or a doctor's office, or a clinic, you're confronted with the clipboard, right? The wooden clipboard that have like little doodles on it from the guests or the patients before you, the metal clip on the top, the duct tape pen, one piece of yarn on the end of it. That's what you experience in healthcare. That's because of a lack of automation. That data should be flowed into their system already. That data should be provided. That information should be known. You should be able to do it at a push of a button without interacting with that old clipboard. So the first thing that they're going to notice is there won't be a clipboard anymore. And then from that point forward, your entire experience will be automated.
Sean, thank you so much for joining us.
Thanks, Chitra.